Hey guys, I'm Courtney Perna. Thanks for listening to GSS Presents Punch Drunk. So on September 5th, we have, no joke, one of the best cards of the entire year. Yes, I'm serious. You may be asking, who is Toscano Boxing Promotions? Well, yeah, they're not top rank, they're not Golden Boy yet, but they do want to push their fighters to greatness, and they're just like a lot of us. They are boxing fans first. They want to be entertained, and they know we want to be entertained, and they don't want cherry-picked fights. Who does, right? So, all you boxing heads, don't miss Best in Boxing September 5th. Today, we're chatting with some of the fighters on that stacked card. I'm talking about King Gio, Giovanni Gonzalez, and Wade Jones III. But first, it's main event fighter Angel Ramos, who's stepping into the ring for the first time with a promoter behind him, and sadly, for the first time since losing his parents in January. Take a look. Joining us now, El Diablito, Angel Ramos. Thank you so much for joining us. I know we're going to get some help translating from Alpha Boxing Promotions owner, Sergio Viaduri. Thank you so much, guys, for joining us. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
We are hanging in there. Thank you. I know that you are just signed recently with Alpha Boxing Promotions, Angel. How does it feel, you know, going into your first training camp? I heard this was your first real training camp.
Okay, ¿cómo me siento para pelear, no?
No, dice que cómo te sientes para pelear, dice que sabe que apenas acabas de firmar con nosotros.
Así es.
Y que cómo te sientes de tener un campamento en forma, como
sí,
este.
Así es. Pues me siento realmente bendecido y agradecido aquí con Sergio, con mi equipo, con señor Raúl Robles, que me trajo aquí con ellos, y pues me siento...
He feels blessed, he feels thankful to his team, to Frankie, to Raúl Robles, the guy doing the physical prep, to his whole team, just for being there and giving the opportunity.
Yeah, well, congratulations on signing. It's hard to believe that you haven't been able, really, until this point, to completely dedicate yourself to the sport of boxing. I mean, your record, 21-1-2, it's hard to believe. So what is it like for you now that you're able to really focus on boxing?
Dice que se siente enfocarte en boxeo, que tienes un récord muy bueno.
Sí, así es. Pues se siente, pues es un boxeo que realmente me gusta, y pues me siento súper bien y súper, le digo, bendecido de poderlo llevar al 100% como se debe.
He feels super good, he feels great, he feels super blessed, and to having a proper training how it's supposed to be.
There you go. So what do you think so far? How has camp been going?
¿Cómo el campamento está ahorita?
Sí, así es. Va muy bien. Estamos echándole muchas ganas. Estamos trabajando duro. Muy enfocados en la pelea.
It's going real good. He's super focused. He's training super hard. And he's going to go for the win.
I know that out of 24 wins, you had 17 knockouts. That's pretty impressive. And we are really looking forward to you on September 5th as the main event. It's the very first pay-per-view for Global Sports Streaming and Best in Boxing. How does that make you feel to have that honor?
Dice que con tu récord de 24-17, que es la primera vez que vas a participar en una cartelera donde hacer pay-per-view. Sí, ¿cómo te sientes tener ese honor?
Sí, así es. Pues me siento muy emocionado, de verdad. Siento que mi carrera... va creciendo a partir de este punto, y pues estoy ahí con toda la disposición para echarle muchas, muchas ganas para ganar.
He feels super great, he feels motivated, and he's gonna do whatever it takes to get the win.
Have you been able to scout Villalobos? What do we know about him, and has your training changed at all, knowing your opponent a little better?
Dice que si ya tuviste chance de ver cómo pelea Villalobos, y que es lo que tuviste que hacer cambios para poderle ganar a tu oponente.
Okay. Pues solamente he visto un pedazo de un video de él, no he podido ver más, pero estoy trabajando yo para pelear contra un zurdo, sabemos que es zurdo, y pues simplemente en eso nos estamos basando.
So we know it's a lefty. He haven't had a chance to research a lot about him because there's not too many videos, but he knows that he's a lefty and he has the right tools and skills to beat him.
All right, I know he's undefeated, so maybe you will hand him his first loss there on September 5th. We'll be pulling for you.
Yeah, dice que sabe que está invicto, pero que posiblemente para que tenga la victoria.
Sí, así es. Sí, yo sé que es un gran peleador, que va invicto con sus peleas, pero aquí estoy entrenando fuerte y estoy muy dedicado y tengo muchas ganas de triunfo, y así lo vamos a demostrar en día 5, primeramente Dios.
I know it's a good fighter. I know he's strong. He's dedicated, but I'm dedicated too, and we're going to go for the win on the 5th.
That's exactly what I was going to say. You are strong and dedicated too as well, sir. Now, I know you looked really good against Max Flores as well, who, of course, is now a world champion. I feel like you've been on the cusp of being a world champion for a while now. Do you think that signing with Alpha Boxing Promotions will help you get to that next step and help put a belt around your waist?
Dice que sabe que tú estuviste a punto de ganar la Max Flores y que has estado al borde de llegar a un campeonato y no lo has hecho. Que si crees que firmando con Alpha, crees que puedas llegar a ser campeón del mundo.
Sí, así es, definitivamente. Yo pienso que esta pelea es un punto clave y después de aquí siento que van a venir todas esas oportunidades.
Yeah, I think this is one of the main key fights for me. And after this, we're going to have another fight, and then we're going to aim for the championship again.
All right. Well, we will definitely be looking forward to that. I also saw your draw against Dwayne Beeman, and it seemed like at times the audience kind of gave you a boost of energy. At times the audience would erupt and just start yelling and chanting for you. How do you think that you can transition into not having an audience and fighting in front of an empty arena? Do you get any of that energy from the audience, or do you not notice them?
Dice que cuando peleaste contra Beeman, que se dio cuenta que las personas te transmitían la energía.
Sí, así
que es. Si, ¿cómo le vas a hacer por ahorita que no hay audiencia?
Sí, así es. Pues, simplemente con las ganas de ganar, yo sé que la gente me respalda, y pues las tengo aquí en el corazón, y vamos a echarle muchas ganas.
I know that people are backing me up, and basically I know they're not going to be able to be there, not because they don't want to, but we're going to fight like if they were going to be there. We're going to try to do our best.
Well, now you have a potentially larger audience, because instead of relying on the gate and people in the region to come physically be there, you have a worldwide audience through global sports streaming on this very first pay-per-view. What are you expecting from your fan base, and have you seen any growth from being able to be streaming out there to the world as opposed to just fighting in front of people in person in your region?
¿Te has dado cuenta si tus fans han crecido a raíz de que saben que vas a pelear y por la publicidad que se la ha dado? ¿O cómo sí. Te sientes acerca de eso?
Sí, sí, así es. Hasta en el Facebook más personas me van agregando y seguidores, pues se van haciendo mis seguidores ahí, al pendiente de mi carrera.
Yeah, my fan base is growing. I constantly get a lot of ads on Facebook and Instagram, all those platforms. So, yeah, my fan base is growing.
I love that, as they should. You're a very talented fighter. And we also have to offer our condolences. I know that you lost your mom and dad in January. How has the transition going back to boxing helped you at all, or has it?
Dice que te mandan sus condolencias, que saben que perdiste a tus padres en enero. Y que, ¿cómo ha hecho eso que cambie tu manera o cómo has cambiado tu manera de boxear?
Sí, así es. Muchas gracias. Pues realmente esto es algo difícil, pero he agarrado mucha fuerza de todo esto positivamente y quiero cumplir lo que mis padres sabían que yo podía hacer, que es convertirme en un campeón.
First of all, thank you for your wishes. Second of all, I'm doing my best. I'm going to prove what my parents wanted me to be, a champion, world champion, and that's where I'm going to get them.
That is a good motivation to have, and I'm sure they are very, very proud of you. So for people who don't know you yet, what else should we know about El Diablito?
Para las personas que no te conocen, ¿qué más deben de saber del Diablito?
Pues simplemente que soy alguien muy sencillo, soy una persona con buena energía siempre, y pues les agradecería de todo corazón que estén al pendiente de mi carrera. Yo voy a dar todo lo de mí, que está en mí, para poder llegar a ser campeón.
So first of all, I just want to let you know that I'm super humble. I'm always energetic, and the only thing I'm going to ask for you guys is just to follow me and just be aware of my fights, and you're not going to be disappointed at all.
All right. Well, we're certainly following the development of you and, of course, the career that you are having and concurrently and, of course, in the future. Should we follow you on social media as well? What are your handles?
¿Qué manejas? Facebook, Instagram, ¿qué es lo que manejas?
Sí, pues principalmente Facebook.
I think the number one is going to be Facebook. Okay. And he's going to start working on his Instagram followers and all those kind of things.
All right. Well, I'll follow you, so make sure you follow back.
Yeah, all right. Dice que te van a seguir y que espero que lo sigas de regreso.
Okay, claro que sí, muchas gracias.
Thank you.
All right. Angel, thank you so much. Sergio, thank you so much. Again, we've got Angel Ramos, El Dablito. He is fighting in the main event against Jorge Villalobos. Let me get that correctly. And they are the main event for September 5th. Boys, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Have a good day.
Best in Boxing presents a night of incredible fight action.
Big punches being landed here on the phone booth on the inside.
He continues to pour it on. Does Jaimez?
Oh. Cantil Main look like he's out on his feet. Firefight, down goes Rosas. Oh, he hits a big shot there. Ramos now. Forcing to cover up.
Not looking good.
Ramos versus Villalobos. Best in Boxing pay-per-view live September 5th, 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern. Presented by Toscano Boxing Promotions, only $9.99. Buy your tickets at bestinboxing.com.
Despite losing his last fight, Giovanni Gonzalez, King Gio, is still confident stepping into the ring on September 5th, and he's enjoying the accolades of being a recognized professional fighter. Well, most of the time. All right, Giovanni King Gio Gonzalez, thank you so much for joining us. What's up, dude?
How's it going? Thank you for having me.
I am so happy to have you here. Now that we're Instagram friends, of course, since we talked last time before the fight down in Tijuana on June 26th, that was one of your first times underneath the new Toscano Boxing Promotions banner. So how has it been with the new camp?
It's been good. You know, the last fight I thought I won. It was a tough fight, but I've watched it multiple times, you know. But it is what it is. It's just a learning experience. You know, so we're just getting ready for this next fight, September 5th.
I was just going to say, you fought Ivan Pinto, and it was really close. I thought you won as well. How do you feel about the support you got from your new team after that fight?
It was good. It was very good because, you know, sometimes, well, actually all the time, a lot of people don't see the type of work we put in behind the scenes. They just see us fight in a square circle, and they don't see us waking up early or going to sleep late or in the middle of the day running and cutting weight and sparring, all that stuff. So, you know, it was a very good support system. You know, my promoter told me they thought I won also. My manager told me I thought I won also. They watched it. I don't think I've spoken to somebody that they said, okay, well, you know, you lost.
Yeah.
I even watched it myself as biased towards my own self to try to score it for him, and I still didn't score it for him. So I'm just like, you know, I just.
When you watch your own fights, do you watch it as a fan? Are you like, oh, that hit? Or are you just like, you know, technically looking at it?
You know, I won't watch my fights even if, you know, even if it's a knockout win, I won't watch it till like several days later. Like, it's just, you know, it's just, I won't even watch it. But when I watch it, then I'll keep watching. I'll try to figure out what's going on. And then if something's going on, I know why I'm doing it. I mean, I was there, you know, so,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, people seem really aggressive, and you seem to want to box him more, but he just was able to walk you down a few times, or at least it seemed like that. What did you learn for your next fight?
You know, a lot of people know me for being an aggressive fighter going forward, but we had to completely change the game plan after the first round because he was a lot heavier than we thought he would be. I don't know how much he came in. We had to box him, and I'm not known as a boxer, but I could box. I just don't do it sometimes. It's just kind of like knocking people out. But I had to box him, and, you know, we had to adjust, and I thought and my team thought we did the right adjustments to win the fight.
I just love the post that you had on Instagram recently with Ricardo Valdovinos and Ivan Pinto next to each other, just like, beat. Yeah. And you were like, I did this. So we know that you hit hard. We know you can fight. You know what I mean? Yeah. Even if those last couple have been really tough, but you've actually had a lot of tough competition lately. I think your last four opponents total, including Brandon Cortez coming up, have one loss total. So yeah. I mean, how has that prepared you going against that top level competition for your continued career and bright future in boxing?
You know, I'm doing what a lot of other fighters, even Elliott fighters, are not doing. I'm fighting tough competition, undefeated fighters in their own hometowns. And not only am I fighting them, I'm fighting them fight after fight, literally right next, like fight after fight after fight. So, you know, it's a, you know, I'm not a cherry picker, you know, I like to fight. And my record states that I've fought some great fighters, some really good fighters. So, you know, at the end of the day, a lot of people, I mean, the other day I was at the store and some big old, you know, Mexican gangster dude came up to me and I was like, man, this guy's gonna, I don't even know this guy, big guy, 6'3". And then he looks at me and I looked at him and he was like, man, I'm a big old fan. I was like, oh shit, what's up, bro? He was like, yeah, man, I saw your last fight. I thought you whooped him, this and that. Just keep it up, bro. You're doing what a lot of other fighters don't do. You're fighting fighters that are actually good and they're on undefeated fighters at fight after fight after fight. So, you know, that's cool. You know, that's dope that, you know, people see that. You know, I don't sit here and cherry pick, you know, so it's just, I'm just going with it.
Exactly. Now, you know, so back up.
Yeah.
Now, isn't that cool though? Because you have such an expanded fan base now. I think that COVID before, you know, we oftentimes, you know, there was a lot of people buying tickets that, you know, were in your region, but now a lot of promoters are talking about the fact that each fighter, even in developmental stages, are becoming worldwide names, certainly because of pay-per-view and things like global sports streaming, putting on the fight that's coming up September 5th. So have you noticed an expansion in your fan base because of that reach?
You know, yes, absolutely. It's actually funny you say that. About 2 days ago, I had somebody from the UK just write me a message, just something short saying, you know, they're a big fan and, you know, they see me as a legend to them because I keep fighting people that are good and early in my career and nobody wants to do that. You know, you got a lot of other fighters, you know, that they're very well taken care of and it's a business and I understand, but, you know, come on now. Yeah, you gotta test yourself. It's either you're good or you're not good, you know, it's as simple as that. Either you want to do it or you don't want to do it.
And you want to see that now in your career. Yeah. You want to see all types of different styles of fighters so that you're not surprised, you know, when you're, you know, 40-1 down the road, yeah, or, you know, when you have a bigger record and more fights. Yep. Coming up, we have the very first Global Sports Streaming Best in Boxing pay-per-view. You are the very first bout in that. So how motivated are you to get a win and to, of course, look good against Brandon Cortez?
You know, it's been a hard training camp, but it's I'm in shape now from the last fight. The last training camp was a little bit tough, I won't lie, because of the whole quarantine. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of weight to cut. But, you know, I'm excited to go out there and put on a show against another undefeated fighter. So, you know, at the end of the day, it's just I want to go out there and perform and give the fans a good fight.
And you always do that for sure. Speaking of fans, of course, again, June 26th in Tijuana, no fans, no audience. How was that for you? Did you notice a difference? Did you miss anything?
You know what? I know you asked me this question before and I said I couldn't really answer it too accurately because I haven't been in that situation before. Now that I've experienced it, it's honestly about the same thing. Once you're in there, you're zoned out. You know, you're in there, it's just you and the other person. You can hear more people, but you're not listening. I mean, you hear them, but you don't hear them because you're so focused on the person in front of you. Mm-hmm. You're just there fighting, you know, it's just pretty much the same thing. Cause when you're fighting in front of a crowd, you're not looking around, looking at people, you know, you're looking at your opponent. Same thing when you're fighting without a crowd, you're not looking around, looking for people. You're just fighting the person in front of you. So it's to me, it's pretty much the same. I mean, you do got the crowd emotions, you know, when you hurt somebody and things mm-hmm. like that. But, you know, it's just, to me, it was pretty much the same thing.
Was it easier to hear your corner or even your opponent's corner? Did that factor in?
Yes, it was. Yes, it was. It was easier to hear both corners. It was, but glimpses, because this past fight, I was on boxing him, moving around. So you're not really focused on what other people are saying. You're just kind of focused on your game plan.
Yeah, I know you don't want to give away your game plan, but you said this training camp for Brandon Cortez has been a little different than the last one. So what have you changed up and what are you focusing on? What do you know about Brandon?
I did see a video on Bradley Cortez, and I can tell you that just like my past three fights, it will be fight of the night because Brandon, he can be an explosive fighter, but the way he fights is sometimes tailor-made for myself because I want him to fight like that with me. Like, Pinto wouldn't engage with me like that. He would just kind of just push his punches and try and pull me down. Brandon is more of a little bit of an explosive fighter, and that's something that I can use against him because I can be extremely explosive if I had the chance to do it. This camp, I've been getting a lot of sparring, a lot of rounds against different looks, heavy, light, forward, a lot of sparring. You know, I'm in great shape. I mean, I did sparring Friday and Saturday, took yesterday off, and I'll be back at just training today and tomorrow, and then back sparring Wednesday and Friday. And it's been a really good camp. So, you know, we're just getting ready for September 5th.
Yeah, I mentioned at the top of the show or at the top of the interview that it was a really close fight. I'm like, there's times where I was like, Pinto's got to go down. Like you had so many good shots on him. Yeah. So we're really excited to see you open up the very first pay-per-view on Global Sports Streaming Best in Boxing on September 5th. Anything you want to say to your fans and maybe even your new fans who are going to see you for the first time now that we've opened it up to the world?
Well, once again, thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it. To all the people out there, make sure you guys tune in September 5th on Global Sports Streaming, Best in Boxing, you know, for Toscano Boxing Promotions. You know, I have the first bout on in the pay-per-view event. I can guarantee you it will be a really good fight. If you don't know who I am, just Google me. You know exactly what I'll be fighting.
And follow him on Instagram like I do. He follows back. So right. He's always got some good entertaining posts.
King Gio.
That's right. Thank you so much, King Gio.
Thank
and we will see you soon.
All right. Thank you for having me.
Best in Boxing presents a night of incredible fight action.
Big punches being landed here on the phone booth on the inside.
He continues to pour it on Des Jaimes.
Oh, Cantu made look like he's out on his feet. Firefight, down goes Rosas. Oh, he hits a big shot there. Ramos now.
Oh,
forcing
man.
To cover up.
Not looking good.
Ramos versus Villalobos. Best in Boxing pay-per-view live September 5th, 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern. Presented by Toscano Boxing Promotions, only $9.99. Buy your tickets at bestinboxing.com.
If you know Wade Jones III, you know he's usually smiling and talking a lot. But that wasn't always the case. He tells us how he went from being a short-tempered kid who was always getting in trouble to the even-keeled, happy-go-lucky guy he is today. Calling in now, Wade Jones III, my Instagram friend. What's up?
Hey, how you doing? How you doing? It's going good.
I'm doing well. We are so excited to see you on September 5th, the very first pay-per-view that Best in Boxing and Global Sports Streaming is putting together. How are you feeling about it?
I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a great card, a great event. I'm coming to put on a show.
Now, I know that you have a lot of fans, and actually, like I said, I mentioned earlier that I'm your Instagram friend. You posted a video after that June 26th fight just saying thank you to everybody. You seem to get a little emotional, just a little tiny bit, just
yeah.
Your fans and everything. What did that win mean to you, and what does it mean to you to have the support of fans in Best in Boxing?
It means a lot to me. You know, when I first started all this, it was just me believing in me. and then trying to fight, figure out how to get to the gym and figure out how to make it happen. So now that I've been grinding and I've been putting in all the work over the years, and now I got all the support behind me, you know, so it's just amazing. It's a great feeling, you know, I got a lot of support, some diehard fans. I don't know how many fans exactly that I have, because it's a bunch of them that I don't even know.
Right.
But I just hear it. Yeah, I just hear it in the grapevine. My coach goes to get a haircut, and the dude had his hair. He's just like, "Oh, it's like, oh, you're his coach," and he's like excited and stuff like that. So it's
that's
like
fantastic.
The stories that I hear from it, and then from what I see, it's cool getting recognized every once in a while. You know, it's pretty cool. It's just a very humbling and very exciting feeling. So I just have to show my gratitude to everybody, you know.
Yeah, and you have a lot of support. I actually heard a rumor that back in March, before the lockdown, you sold 10,000 tickets to a fight in Stockton.
I sold more than that, actually. I passed my goal was 10,000, and then I think I sold almost 12,000. I think it was like 11,000 something, and wow. We had like a week left. We had like a week left, so that was dope. I everybody lags last minute, so I was thinking I was probably going to get at least 12. You know. It's still cool, man. I can't wait till we can bring it back home. You know, maybe it's going to be bigger. Well, if it's the same, you know, I don't care. I just can't wait to fight in front of the home team.
I mean, at 4-0, you're fairly new to the game still. So where does that fan base come from?
Man, it's just word of mouth. It's just like, because I've been, like I said, I've been putting, it was just me. It was just me and it was just me believing in me. And then it's me, my coach believing in us, the squad believing in us. So it's, I've been going gym to gym, getting my respect, you know. Staying humble, just, you know, I don't post stuff online. I'm a very humble guy, cool guy. I don't have a short temper anymore. So I just very thankful. So I always show love to everybody, everywhere I go, anytime. A lot of people don't know I box. I don't even mention it unless it's like for a monetary opportunity or something like that. I won't even mention it. When I'm out, I let other people say it, and then I'll confirm it and stuff like that. So I think that's what it is, just all the love I've shown, all the respect I got in the gym. Everyone just came together and was just like, supporting me, you know. They and then, you know, they seen my last couple fights, so they're excited to see it live and stuff like that. So I think that's what it was.
Now, you mentioned that you don't have a short temper anymore. I know that you got into boxing because you got into a little trouble first, had to go to Florida with your dad, and it there. So has the sport helped you, even though now you fight professionally, has this sport helped you to kind of control that emotion or the explosiveness or anger or whatever it was that fueled a short temper before?
It's a combination of a lot of things, but the sport definitely is a combination to the people I have in my ear now, the role models that I have now, the goals that I have now, because back then I didn't have any goals. I didn't want to be anything. You know, I was like at 12 years old, I thought I was going to die at like 18. So it's like, that's just where my mindset was at. So me getting into boxing, I developed goals. I met my coach. He's been getting all the animosity off me and the chip that I had on my shoulder before. He's been breaking it down. We've just been growing together, you know. So that's why I can control my temper a lot more. A lot of stuff rolls off my back. I don't even think of anything because I'm just so happy. You know, I'm so happy with how life's going for me. And the future, I feel like my future is extremely bright. I just got to stay alive, stay focused, stay out of trouble, you know. So that's all I'm worried about.
Interesting, though, that you thought you might die at 18, and now I hear interviews with you, and you say you want to die a legend. That's a big change in mindset. Yeah. So congratulations on that. What would you say to maybe some younger kids or some aspiring fighters that are kind of maybe feeling some of that angst that you felt or hopelessness even that you might have felt as a kid?
I'd tell them just if it's boxing that they want to do, I'd tell them just stay in the gym. Let all that out in the ring, on the bag, on the mitts. Let that fuel you to work hard. You know, whatever's hurting you, just when you feel that hurt, just go out and go run, go work out, exercise. Let's get released the body and just stay out the way. That's the best thing I can tell them. Just stay out the way and invest into yourself. You know, that's what I did. I got anything that I make. That I can from boxing, especially anything I make from boxing, I invest it right back into boxing. Anything I make with my job, I put it into boxing. So all the money that's put into me, that's invested into me, or that I make, I invest it into myself. You know, so I tell them invest into their boxing career if that's what they really want to do. And by also investing into your boxing career, that means you gotta keep yourself healthy. You know, don't do drugs, don't drink. work extremely hard and you'll do fine, you know, and if they don't believe in you now, they will later. I'm like living proof.
Yeah, you're doing more than fine. That's for sure. Now, we mentioned the support of a large fan base regionally. Do you think that those fans will follow you behind the paywall when we have this pay-per-view? You know, do you think that they're going to keep watching? And what do you think about expanding your fan base to global now that you are being streamed on pay-per-view?
I think they're going to keep watching because I tell them where they can watch it. And they're like, oh, yeah. I tell them how much it is. They're like, oh, yeah, we're watching it. We're tuning in. They're sending the link, post the link. So, you know, that's all I got to do is just do my part and making sure that they have access to it and they'll tune in. You know, it's, pay-per-view isn't that much. It's $9.99, bestinboxing.com. So
I know that's way cheaper than a ticket at the gate there too. So,
yes.
But how does it affect you being such a charismatic guy, not having the audience? Because I know that was the case in June 26th in Tijuana. You didn't have the audience there. What are you learning from that experience that you're taking into the September 5th fight?
The main difference between not having the audience is which was what I thought it would be is when they announce your name, no one's cheering for you. Really, it's no one that's cheering. That's like the only difference when they announce that you want to know that you don't hear a bunch of screaming. And if you hit them with a good shot, you don't hear a bunch of screaming. Besides that, it's regular. It's not really like a big deal to me because I'm charismatic at times, but in my regular life, I'm extremely serious. I'm real focused. And then in the gym, if I'm with my team and we're playing around after, then I joke around. But most of the time, I'm very serious and very business-minded. So when it comes time to fight, that's exactly the side that comes out is I'm ready to get it. So
the crowd. That's for sure. And you certainly had to work on June 26th. I mean, Hector Hernandez was not an easy fight. Yeah. You landed some really good shots right on his chin. Dude just kept coming at you. It's like he wouldn't drop. What do you feel about that fight?
I'm thankful for that fight, man. I learned a lot from that fight. That's what takes is going to help build me as a fighter. You know, these tough fights. My first couple fights, I got those guys out of there immediately. So it wasn't too much learning. It was just a good confidence boost, you know. And my last couple fights, I went the distance with some real tough dudes. I wanted to win. I kept coming, kept pushing, kept fighting. The fight before last, I knocked the dude down. I didn't think he was going to get up when I landed there, but he got up. He took a beating after that, but he took it, and then the next guy, he just kept coming nonstop, trying to beat me. I had to dig deep, I had to grind, and so I just know it's just elevating me as a fighter. It's the early stages of my career. All that matters at this stage of my career is that I win. So as long as I get the win and don't get hurt, then that's all that matters to me.
Well, you mentioned that your first couple of fights, I think they were first round knockouts, right? So
yes, ma'am.
Those ended quickly. You had mentioned that you wanted to get some more rounds in. So now that your last two fights have really gone the distance, do you still want that? Like, how do you feel now?
I'm gonna let it come. You know, I'm gonna let it's God's plan. You know, let the universe, you know, do what it's gonna do. But I'm always, you know, like they say, you don't get paid for overtime. So I'm always gonna be ecstatic if I can get them out of there early. If the opportunity presents itself, I'm gonna get them out of there. If not, then I'm ready for whatever. Four rounds. When I go six, I'm gonna be ready for six. So it is what it is. I don't mind. But you know, of course, the fans want to see knockouts. So I wanna do that too.
But the fans want to see great fights, and I think that you also showed that you've got a strong chin and your endurance was fantastic because you needed it against Hernandez on June 26th. Now, I think that seeing those different kinds of fighters and having those different kinds of fights this early in your career is an advantage. So how do you feel when you face other fighters with different styles?
I agree. I think it's an advantage because later on, it's all going to play a part. Your opposition, your sparring, all that's going to show once you start going up to the top level and everything's competition starts getting tougher. You're going to see who's going to fold. You know, I'm in these tough fights early in my career and, you know, I'm these tough tests and I'm passing them. So, you don't see me looking like I'm ready to quit. Like my eyes big wide. Like I don't want to do this. I'm built for this, and I'm gonna keep showing that.
And I know that you're the type of guy. You said you've never turned down a fight. I feel like you're the type of guy that's like, whatever, I'll fight anybody. But you've also said that it doesn't matter who you're fighting. You're always nervous, not because you're scared of the opponent or afraid of losing, but you said you're always nervous because you want to do your best and you want to look good. So how does that help with your training and how does that help with your, I guess, energy and the adrenaline when you have stepping into the ring?
So it's weird because I'm not nervous the day the fight's there, and like when it's time to fight, I'm not nervous at all. I'm like the least nervous. Everyone else is nervous, and I'm just chilling. But before that, in training, I use it as fuel, like, you know, the little anxious, nervous, and I'm not gonna let anybody do anything to me. So if they're out there to do something to me, they gotta earn it. They don't have to really do it. So I'm not letting anybody do nothing to me. So that's how I train. You know, I train hard as hard as I can. I put the work in, and when it comes fight time, I'm relaxed because I already know I put the work in. I did everything I possibly could, and then I just leave it up to the man upstairs.
Yeah, and you train very hard. How has it been different through this COVID roller coaster? Things were shut down in March. You talked about selling all those tickets. You know, that boxing show was shut down. And then now it's like, well, maybe it's actually even better because now streaming has become so important and your audience is worldwide. So how has that roller coaster been for you since March, and how has it affected your training?
So this time around, I was aware. So I just got right back to the gym. So life has been kind of back to normal, almost, you know, as normal as it can be, you know, because I just work, train. That's how it was before. So that's why I'm back to that. So it's cool. I feel like I adjusted to it. I feel like I adjusted to it. I'm ready for it now. I'm going to be more prepared than I was last time.
So, what do you think about the sport itself being able to pivot and not only survive these restrictions and kind of this new reality we all live in, but thrive? I think combat sports in general have really been the only sport to keep moving forward and innovate like we are here at Global Sports Streaming. So how do you feel about the sport in general being able to pivot?
I love it. You know, I love the sport, and people always like been trying to say boxing is dying for years, but it's not, and it won't. It's one of the oldest sports around, you know. And, you know, it's even older than that because it was something else. You know, the gladiator fighting, you can relate that back to boxing. So it's been around forever. People have been entertained by people going at it since the beginning of time. And I don't think it's going to stop anytime soon. So I'm glad that the sport has adjusted like the fighters have to in the sport. So I'm excited. I don't think we're slowing down anytime soon. I think it's just going to stock's going to rise with boxing.
I don't think you are slowing down anytime soon. Is there anything else boxing fans need to know about Wade Jones III?
Follow me on Instagram, Wade Jones III, or It's Wade Jones, ITSWADJONES, and stay away from my Twitter.
You got it. Good luck to you again. I think you're the second fight on the card for September 5th. Pay-per-view on Global Sports Streaming and Best in Boxing. Wade Jones III, let me get it right here, is going to be taking on, who are you taking on? I just forgot.
Oh, I don't know.
You don't even know. I don't know. Who is he fighting, somebody. Armando? This is so funny. I was so focused on doing your interview and I totally forgot who you're fighting right now.
No, I just got the...
Oh, we just got your opponent. Okay. So maybe this will be breaking news to you. Dun, dun, dun.
I don't think Wade even knows.
Yeah. Goodbye. So I said breaking news for you. He's on his phone frivolously right now trying to get your opponent. This was not planned because obviously, but I was like, oh, wait, who's he fighting? I don't even know.
Francisco
Parra. P-A-R-R-A. Francisco Parra. So Google him, watch some videos, and get ready for September 5th.
Let's get it.
He's from Tijuana. So that's what Armando's yelling at me over there. So we will be ready for you. We'll be pulling for you, and good luck to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a great day.
Be sure to watch Best in Boxing's pay-per-view event on September 5th. It's one of the best cards in the entire sport, for real. I'm Courtney Perna. I'll be broadcasting from Las Vegas for the prelim bout starting at 6 p.m. Pacific time, 9 p.m. Eastern time. And the fighters, they'll be live from the fight capital of Mexico, Tijuana.